Hello Taurus, how are you? Welcome to my channel Star 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 and welcome to your reading. So Taurus, this is your reading for the month of May. You can consider this as a post mid-month reading. And Taurus, this is a general reading. Please take what resonates, leave what doesn't. Energies might be vice versa and time is fluid. Okay. Taurus, I would appreciate if you would hit like, share and subscribe and comment down below if you find yourself getting resonated with this reading. Okay, also Taurus, I've started with extended reading, so if you're interested in the same, if you're excited to know what your what are the deepest and the innermost feelings about your person for you, if you're excited to know what action they will take towards you, what is the likely conclusion of the situation, also if you're interested to know interested to get advice on your life, your money, your career, you can go ahead and you can check out the extended reading. The link for the extended reading has been provided in the description box below. And also in the comments section, you can click on that link and it will lead you to the extended reading on Vimeo. Make sure you follow me on Vimeo. Make sure you follow me on YouTube, okay? As far as this reading on YouTube is concerned, Taurus, what I'm going to do is I'm going to place a couple of cards over here. They will represent your energy. Then I'm going to place a couple of cards over here. They will represent the energy of the person you are thinking about, you are dealing with. In between, I'm going to place a couple of cards and they will represent the mutual energy between you and your person. Thereafter, I'm going to pull out some cards from another deck and they will be the general messages. They will be the non-love messages for you and your person. Later on, I'm going to pull out some oracle cards and we'll see what are the messages from higher powers, what are the messages from the universe for you. Thereafter, I have added a new segment and you know, with this segment, we'll check who is the new person that is coming towards you, Taurus. Okay, so I'm going to describe this new person. I'll also describe the kind of relationship you'll have with this new person. Okay, all right, let's get started, Taurus. So we have is Seven of Wands for you, Knight of Pentacles, then we have is the Ace of Wands, Taurus. For your person, we have is the Page of Cups, the Hermit, King of Swords. Mutual energy is that of Eight of Cups and Temperance. So if I have to talk about the zodiac signs, you may be dealing with a Virgo, you may be dealing with a Sagittarius in particular. Otherwise, I see a very strong presence of fire and water. Okay, you may be dealing with Aries, Leo, Sag, you may be dealing with Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Okay, if the sign pops up, all the better. Let's not remain fixed on the signs. And somehow I'm also hearing Gemini and Libra. Okay, so Taurus, we have Seven of Wands, Knight of Pentacles, and Ace of Wands for you. Taurus, you are somehow, I feel that you are a bit tired and you're a bit exhausted standing up for yourself. Okay, you're a bit tired, you know, people misunderstanding you. You're tired, people underestimating you. Okay, you're tired, you are like, just because I'm nice, I'm kind, okay, I'm loving, I'm caring, and I have this nurturing attitude doesn't mean that I'm weak, doesn't mean I'm going to allow you to walk over me, okay? So, you are tired of people primarily underestimating you, okay? And you are defending yourself, you're standing up strong, but there is an element where you are like, enough, I don't want to fight this. I'm fighting with people who are not capable of understanding where I'm coming from. Okay, so it's like you are giving up this fight, not because not because you don't want to show how right you are, but you are giving up the fight because you're dealing with people who will never understand what are you trying to say. Even if they understand, they will always make efforts to pull you down again and again. Okay, so it is a sort of a vicious cycle that you're going through right now, and you are like, I'm fighting a fight which has no end. Okay, so you're feeling like you're fighting something which has no end. So you are somehow, you're feeling the kind of environment you are in right now, Taurus, you're feeling that there is a bit of suffocation. Every step you take, there is a trigger point which is being kept for you. Okay, every second you breathe, okay, you are being triggered. Every minute you are surviving in that atmosphere, people around you are triggering you. Okay, it's like your breathing triggers, you are exhaling frustration. So you feel that this is not the atmosphere I want to stay in. This is not a progressive. You come across as a very progressive minded person, Taurus. Okay, you come across as very progressive minded. It may have happened that you have got you have changed your place because you are feeling like I don't fit in over here. Okay, you may have left someone in the past because you think that I couldn't resonate myself with the people around me. I couldn't align myself with them. Okay, so you are moving out on a soul journey, Taurus, where you are trying to find, not just trying to find what is it that you want, what is it that you suits you the most, but you're also trying to find an atmosphere. You are trying to find like-minded people. You're trying to find people with a lot of positivity, with a lot of progressive mindset, with a lot of soul tribe. You're trying to find your soul tribe. That's what I'm feeling, Taurus. Okay, and you also want a place and a community where you're feeling stable, you don't want to surround yourself with people or a situation or a relationship where you are being constantly triggered for something. Okay, so with that Knight of Pentacles, I clearly feel that you're craving for stability, be it in a relationship, be it in any damn situation, right? Be it your personal affairs with your family, your relationship with your family, your work situation, or your romantic relationship, there is a lot of instability in and around. And with that Ace of Wands, I feel that universe is like, yes, you are on the right path, and you are on the right path. However, the journey has not ended as of now. Okay, let me give you a weapon. Okay, let me give you something. Let me instill something inside you, which will help you overcome the minor obstacles or the challenges that you're going to face in your journey. Okay, look at this. The Knight of Wands is proceeding ahead, and universe is like, I know you are proceeding on the right path. You may face some minor challenges. Let me gift you something. Let me give you a tool. Let me give you a weapon which you can utilize for yourself to overcome the challenges. Okay, so I can definitely see that universe is trying to protect you. Universe is watching you. Your spirit team is watching you. Your ancestors are watching you. And you have set yourself out on a journey, Taurus. You have set yourself out on a journey. And this journey is to find yourself. Journey is to grow spiritually. Journey is to meet the like-minded people. Journey is to surround yourself. Journey is to find home. Taurus, you have set yourself out on a journey to find home. Okay, and as far as your person is concerned, we have Page of Cups, the Hermit, and the King of Swords. So Taurus, your person, there is lot of love. There is lot of love, but at the same time, I also feel that the need to have you in their life is so much. They want you back in their life so desperately. Like, of course, there are these realizations, there are these big realizations running in their mind. They know that mistreated Taurus. They know that whatever happened was not good. They know that they are, their own acts and their own behavior is calling on for losses in their own life. Okay, so they are going through their losses because of their own behavior. They're understanding that, they're recognizing that it's not just their own loss, but at the same time they're also recognizing that this is not what they should have done with Taurus. They hurt Taurus. Okay, they want to come towards you with an apology. Okay, this person wants to come towards you with an apology, and not just that, they also want to surrender themselves to the situation. They want to surrender themselves to this connection and surrender themselves to you. Okay, they want to come towards you with a very strong apology and they want to surrender themselves. Okay, they are like, I'm very sorry, I know I was totally wrong, I shouldn't have done this, but I need you. I need you, and wait for me. I need you, don't leave me. Okay, so this person has had, they have had some quick realizations, Taurus, I must say. Okay, you are also dealing with someone who is intelligent, but maybe they may have got swayed a bit in between, but they have had their realizations. The only thing they are scared of, that you are going to act extremely defensive. They are scared that you're going to act extremely defensive. This person is going to come towards you. They want to stop you. With that mutual energy, I clearly feel that they want to stop you. They want to submit themselves to this connection. They want to surrender themselves to this connection. They are also praying to the God that please stop Taurus. Don't allow Taurus to walk away from you. Okay? I feel that Taurus, something you are also feeling, that you are also getting pulled back. Though you are like, you know, if this person has to come towards me, they can come towards me. But that doesn't mean I'm going to stop my journey. Okay, so you are continuing with your journey, but somehow you're feeling that you need to stop and look back. Okay, someone is calling you. That's the kind of a feeling you're getting, because though we have Eight of Cups over here, we have Temperance card next to Eight of Cups. So even if you have started walking on your own journey, there is a kind of a voice you're hearing that stop, stop, wait, turn around. Look around, look back. Okay, so whether this, the intention is to come towards you, the intention is to surrender you, surrender to you. Okay, but will they really come back? What action they will take towards this? What is the likely conclusion of the situation, Taurus? What are their innermost, deepest feelings about you? Okay, you can check that out in the extended reading. The link for the extended reading has been provided in the description box. The link has been provided in the comments section also. You can click on that link and it will lead you to the extended reading on Vimeo. I also provide advice on life, money, and career, which is equally important. Just the way the advice on love is also important. Okay, so never ever miss any sort of advice. Right, so now let's pull out some cards and see what are the general messages for you and your person, Taurus. Let's see what are the general messages for you and your person. And we have is the Ten of Cups. We have is the Hanged Man. Then we have is the Five of Swords. Queen of Cups, then we have Four of Pentacles, and we have is the Knight of Pentacles. This person is thinking that you are holding yourself back. You have a lot of love for them, okay? You have a lot of love for them, but you are clearly holding themselves back. And this person is envisioning a long-term future with you, long-term commitment, long-term future. For some of you, they are also envisioning marriage, because this King of Pentacles is looking in this direction. For some of you, Taurus, I feel that there is also a new person. I'm also getting a sense of a new energy from this King of Pentacles. Okay, as far as you are concerned, I feel that there is a lot of abundance coming your way. Somehow I'm getting career vibes from this. Okay, whatever you had asked for, whatever you were wishing for, that is about to get fulfilled with respect to your career. If you wanted a promotion, if you wanted some sort of a job change, if you wanted a pay rise or something like that, okay, whatever you were trying to manifest when it comes to your career, that is about to get fulfilled. Okay, with that Five of Swords and the Hanged Man with next to one another, I feel that Taurus, you will recognize very soon. You are about to recognize who are truly meant to stay in your life, and who are not meant to stay in your life. Okay, you are going to recognize that very soon with that Five of Swords and Hanged Man next to one another. Okay, so let's see what is your advice, and after this we'll see who is the new person that is coming towards you, Taurus. Okay, so stay tuned in till the end. So let's see what is your advice in general. So we have blossoming abundance. I told you, right? We have caring connections, we have anxiety, and we have patience. Okay, so with that blossoming abundance, I feel that especially I'm getting career vibes. I also got career vibes from Hanged Man and the Ten of Cups. Okay, whatever you were wishing, okay, that is about to happen, and you're going to be very happy about it. I also see your love life is about to get stabled pretty soon. Okay, something that with respect to love, right, the kind of love you wanted, you know, where there is an equal give and take, the person is going to treat you really nice, person will be loyal and all that. Okay, so whatever criterias you had in your mind with respect to your love partner, that is about to get fulfilled. All the checklist will be tick marked. Okay, with that anxiety, what are you anxious about, Taurus? Well, please tell me what a Taurus is anxious about. What are you anxious about, Taurus? Ace of Swords. Some sort of a communication. Okay. Six of Swords. Yeah, there is some sort of a communication which is making you anxious. And you have reached a crossroads, Taurus, where you are about to decide something. Okay. It may require some sort of a sacrifice. Okay. And that is making you a bit anxious. Why I'm saying sacrifice is because with that Six of Swords, you're moving away from something, right? It may be like you may get an offer overseas, and for that you will have to leave your existing home, you may have to leave your family, you may have to leave your existing setup. That is making you a bit anxious, but have patience. Things are going to work out in your favor. Have some patience. Right, Taurus, let's see who is the new person that is coming towards you. Now in this segment I'm going to describe the new person coming towards you. I'm going to describe the kind of relationship you'll have with that new person, and this segment is applicable for everyone, whether you are single, whether you are in separation, you want to move on, you don't want to move on. Okay, so who is the new person that is coming towards Taurus? Okay, who is the new person that is coming towards Taurus? And we have is Page of Pentacles, Four of Wands, Seven of Wands, Page of Cups, Lovers, Six of Pentacles, Emperor, The World, Hermit, Queen of Swords. Okay. So Taurus, right away the kind of impression I'm getting over here is, first of all, this person may be younger to you. This person may be younger, or this person may be young looking person. Okay, and I would suggest that don't go by the looks. Okay, even if they look very young, even if they talk, the first impression may be like, you know, they are very young and younger, or you know, and you will draw conclusions and assumptions like maybe they don't have much worldly wisdom, maybe they have not experienced life much. Okay, so I would suggest don't go by their looks, because even if they are looking younger, okay, they have gone through a lot, they have like amazing wisdom. Probably this person will be much more mature than you. Okay, and they look young because they are very much into fitness. This person takes care of their body, and they take care of the way they look and appear, but at the same time this person is very, very highly mature. As in, like, slowly and gradually, the way you will, like, you know, when you will start knowing and understanding this person, you will be surprised, Taurus. Like, the kind of maturity they bring in the conversations, the kind of wisdom they bring in the conversations, and you will be so impressed, you will be so surprised, and you will be like, wow, I never thought that you would be so wise enough, I never thought that you would be so mature enough, okay? So don't go by their looks. Like, I feel somehow I'm getting that initially you will be reluctant, or initially they, like, once they approach, you may dismiss them. Okay, of course, this person will keep on chasing you till the time you you get convinced. Okay, but I would suggest that try and approach this situation with an open mind. Okay, because this person is the love of your life, Taurus. Okay, this person is the love of your life. I'm getting some twin flame and soulmate vibes. Okay, so as far as money, financial settlement and career is concerned, this person looks very well settled. Okay, they look very well settled, and they are some sort of a, you know, they come with leadership qualities. They are a leader person. They may be a managerial person wherever they are working, but at the same time, this person is also doing a lot of other activities. And they want to pull you. They will like to pull you in whatever they are doing. Okay. So they will make sure that both of you work together. The working hours are spent together. You know, outside working hours are being spent together. So they will make sure that they keep you around them. Okay. Because that is what makes them happy. They want you in front of your eyes all the time. That's what I'm feeling. They want to see you all the time, and seeing you makes them happy. Seeing you all the time makes them very happy. So this person will make sure that they pull you in whatever they are doing, okay, so that you stay in and around them all the time. And they will also help you rise up, okay? They will also help you rise up a lot. In fact, this person has this kind of, you know, they build people. This person is a true leader. They build people, they build leaders under them, okay? And that's what they're going to do with you as well. With the World card, I feel that this person may be staying far away from you, and you're going to meet them when this person comes to your country, your city, your state, for some work reasons, and that's how you're going to bump into them. I don't see you meeting at a workplace. I see somewhere, like, you know, you're literally meeting in a coffee shop or something. This person will approach you. This person will, you may meet them while traveling inside the flight or something like that, okay? When you are outside, that's when you're going to meet them, okay? And this is going to be an amazing, fun sort of a relationship. This person will bring a lot of excitement, will bring a lot of enthusiasm in this relationship. They will also, they will encourage you to look good. Like, you know, they will be like, why don't you start gymming with me? Why don't you come for a jog with me? Or, you know, why don't you start, let's do some yoga together and meditation together. Okay, so this person will help you reach your beautiful looking body. So this person will literally pep you up. Like, this person will keep on encouraging you and motivating you. I'm getting very, very strong, leadership vibes. I'm getting very strong vibes where one person is encouraging another, and both of you will keep on encouraging one another a lot. You will also keep on giving this person a lot of suggestions and feedbacks, and like, this, why don't you do this, why don't you do that. Especially while shopping, both of you will go together and you'll help them do a lot of shopping, and what looks good on them and what doesn't. Like, I see a lot of things doing together. Let's do things together. Let's do things together. Okay. Of course, you will also like to have your own space. They will also like to have their own space. So, but anyways, I see both of you will keep on traveling a lot for your work reasons, and that will give you your required space. Okay. But otherwise, whenever it is possible, whenever both of you are in the same city, I see that you both of you will make sure that let's spend the time together. Okay. Alright, so this is a very amazing relationship, progressive. I told you, right? Yeah, even you are a progressive minded person. So that's kind of a relationship I see over here. Alright, Taurus, I hope this resonates. Please hit like, share, and subscribe, and comment on below. Till then, bye bye.